Hello everyone, and welcome to this video about AES67. Since Lake Controller version 6.7, the D Series and the PLM Plus Series amplifiers has been supporting AES67 as an alternative protocol for networked audio transport. This enables native audio exchange with several other audio products such as Q-LAN and RAVENNA. Today I'll guide you through the process on how to set up a device using AES67. In this example, I'll be using a Q-SYS core. So let's start. I have a 250 core and I have configured it so I have analog inputs coming into the core. So I'll go here. And under streaming I/O, I'll select a AES67 transmitter. Let's add that. So that's basically all I have to do here in Q-SYS. If we do a save to core and run. So we can see here that we have my analog stereo input coming into the Q-SYS core, and that's connected to the AES67 transmitter. So I have my audio going out on AES67 here. Here we can see the multicast address, the stream name, and that is what we also can see here in the Dante controller that we need to do the actual routing. As you can see here, I have one D Series D80 and one PLM Plus 12K on the network. So let's go into the Lake controller. Let's use my D80 in this example. So this is from factory reset. So let's go here and let's enable Dante, and under Dante we have an option to enable the AES67 mode. When that is pressed, the device will do an automatic power cycle to go into the AES67 mode, and when AES67 is enabled, as we can see here, only 48 kHz of mode is available. So there, now it's back online again. When using AES67, it's very important to have at least one device that can be the AES67 master on the network. And in this case, I have already pre-configured it to be out of the default Dante slave-only mode. So if we go back to the Dante controller under clock status, we can see that my D8 is now the AES67 master. So that's good. So let's go to the routing view. Let's expand the D80 and let's expand the Q-SYS Core AES67 transmitter, and let's create a subscription. There, now that's done. Let's go back to the Lake controller to see what it looks like from inside here. We can see that our Dante receivers have the AES67 subscriptions. So the Q-SYS core shows up here, but we can't do any actual routing from within the Lake controller. The routing must be done from the Dante controller. But once the routing is done, we can see it from inside the Lake controller, and we can also remove subscriptions. But I can't redo them, so now I must go back here and put it back. We can see that my Dante receivers in the input router have selected the AES67 audio flow, and coming into the device we have the AES67 audio. So that's all on creating an AES67 subscription on the D Series or PLM Plus Series amplifiers. I'll walk you through how to set up a PLM Plus or D Series amplifier as an AES67 transmitter. And I will be using a Q-SYS core as my AES67 receiver. So let's start. Here I have my D Series amplifier that is configured with analog stereo input, and it's this signal that I want to transmit out on AES67. So first I need to confirm that I at least have one device that does not have the Dante slave only setting enabled, so I need to remove that, and I need to do a power cycle of the device. So let's quit the lake controller and use the updater power cycle option. So this will soon come online again. So there are my D-Series back online. Still have the analog stereo input coming in, and now we can see that the slave only option is disabled. If we look in the Dante controller, we have the D-Series, we have the PLM, and we have our Q-SYS core here on the network as well. So let's go into the D-Series. To be able to configure this for AES67 transmitting, I need to go into the Dante configuration, enable Dante, enable AES67. As we see, the device will automatically power cycle the Dante module in this case. There it is back online, and now we have AES67 enabled. I think it shortly will lock. Yeah, so there everything is okay. We also need to go into the transmit tab and enable transmit outputs. And here we can see that from inside the lay controller we cannot configure any of the AES67 transmit flows. That is solely done from the Dante controller. But I need to configure what I want to transmit, and that is done from this view, from the output configuration. And in this case, it is the analog inputs that I want to transmit. So let's disconnect those from wherever they are and transmit analog input 1 out on AES and Dante output 1, and analog input 2 out on AES and AES67 output 2. So that's all I have to do in the lake controller. Let's go to Q-SYS designer. I need to add a streaming IO AES67 receiver. So let's add that. And let's just save to core and run. Cool. So now this is running. Let's go to the Dante controller. Let's go to my D80. Go to transmit. Click this create new multicast flow, select AES67, select channel 1 and 2, and create. So now I have created an AES67 transmit flow. And if I look inside the lake controller, Dante configuration transmit, we can see that channel 1 and 2 is in transmit flow 32. That's also what we see here in the Dante controller, flow 32. So let's go back to Q-SYS designer. Let's select the D80, flow 32, and there we see, there we have my analog input coming into the D80, transmitted out on AES67 on the network and picked up by the Q-SYS core. And from here I can route it wherever I want. In this video I'll show how the D80 can act as a bridge between the AES67 audio to Dante. So as I did in the part 1 video, I have my Q-SYS core with analog inputs. Those are transmitted out via the AES67 transmitter out to AES67. I did the subscriptions from Dante Controller so that the D80 subscribe to two of the AES67 channels, and I have the AES67 audio coming into the Dante receiver. The Dante receiver is used in the input router, and I can see that my module input has the AES67 audio. So now I want my D80 to act as a bridge from AES67 to Dante. To do that, I need to go into the Dante configuration menu of the D80. I go to the transmit tab and I enable transmit outputs. Here we can see that we have the Dante transmits, as well as we can see if we have any AES67 transmits. So we could also transmit the AES67 audio coming in out on the new AES67 flow. But in this video, I'll show you how to do it from Dante. And it's not very different from doing a normal Dante transmit out of the D Series device. So I'll just go to the output routing. I can take my Dante receivers, and here I have my two AES67 inputs coming in, and I can transmit them out on Dante again. So let's go into the PLM Plus amplifier. I'll go in here, I'll enable Dante. I'll go to, as you see, I don't have the AES67 enabled. If we go to the receive now, we can see that the D80 shows up, but as it's the D80 is in the AES67 mode, it's restricted to 48K only. So I'll need to go and select the 48K sample rate also for the PLM Plus series amplifier. I'll go back to receive. I'll select the D80, and I can subscribe to the first two channels. The receiver is connected. The Dante receiver is used in the input router. And if we look here, now we have the analog inputs coming into the Q-SYS core, going through to AES67 to the D80, and from the D80 to Dante to the PLM Plus series amplifier. If we look here, we can see that the D80 is now the transmitter for the PLM Plus series, and we get the signal present here and all the other benefits that we get from using a Dante flow. We get the latency options as well. That's all on creating a bridge between AES67 and Dante. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to add them below. See you next time.